Wonder Words is an app that lets parents generate children's stories using AI. Developer Felipe used Bubble to launch it for web, iOS, and Android.
A few days, I sent my first version to App Store because it's so easy, né? Because the editor is the same, the database is the same, the backend workflow is the same.
Bubble for native mobile is still in beta, but many developers like Felipe are already publishing mobile apps that you can download from the App Store on your phone right now. In this series, we tour real Bubble apps with the developers who built them. Let's take a closer look at Wonder Words with Felipe. So awesome to meet you. Thanks so much for doing this. Could you go ahead and start us off by just introducing yourself and how you found Bubble?
Yeah, sure. My name is Felipe, I'm from Brazil. My professional career, I have a soft house since 2011. And 5 years ago, I know Bubble. Then I saw the opportunity to create my own project, transform your ideas in real projects. It's so good, so powerful.
Do you want to share your screen and start taking us through? I'd love to know a little bit more about what your app is and why you wanted to build it.
Yeah, I'm a graphic designer. I like to work with text, image, stories, book. Then last year, I saw the opportunity because I wanted to try AI model. So I put together these things to create a platform to create a short children stories. Then this web version, here is a regular project in Bubble. Then the parents put this information in. I send it to AI model. In this project, in the first version, I apply Hugging Face AI models. It's totally free, but for MVP, for tests, it's so good, but in production, Hugging Face sometimes don't work very well. But here, using AI model, it's possible to create the text, the image, here the read or listen the story. Then after, I receive the access to mobile. I would like to share these details because for Bubble developer is a real opportunity to offer a multi-platform project because it's possible to use all backend workflows. Another key point I think is to use the same database, so good. And what you need to do is recreate, remade the front end. It's important because you want to offer a native experience. Then you need to use native components. Like here is a mobile editor, is the quite same, it's the same experience that I use it to Bubble, yeah. But here we have a specific components like horizontal list, short list, sheet. It's so common as like a model. Then here, let me share another view. It's a mobile view in page. It's possible to have to organize and manage your project in the same screen. It's possible to change so easy. Maybe I want to change something in web page. Now I can choose a mobile view. That is so practical. In my experience, maybe one week because this web platform was done in few days because it's not so many screens. Yeah. In few days, I finish this adaptation and this conversion to Bubble using these specific components.
You had a full web app already with the database, with the backend workflows, but you needed to translate it into native mobile. Is there any part of your mobile app build that comes to mind when you think of the kind of like challenge or opportunity of converting your pre-existing designs into mobile?
Yeah, you need to rethink, because the experience mobile is, yeah, it's totally different in web platform. Then you need to understand how work these components, because for example, in web platform, you have only a repeat group, yeah, one query. You can change, yeah, organize, change some settings, but in mobile, you have more option. You have components, you have different view types, yeah, vertical list, section list. Then you need to understand how these components, these settings work to translate your layout, your front end from web to mobile. I think this, because I design, I have experience to create screens, prototype using Figma, then is a good exercise. You can choose for reference example in offer to final clients a best experience in mobile. It's totally different. You create a responsible web platform and wrapper embed in, so common this approach, embed inside an app. Now Bubble offer a real tools and real opportunity to create real mobile, native mobile. Then this part of this project is not, I think it's not possible to jump. It's the main part to recreate your screens.
Was there a particular mobile specific component or element that became your favorite when you were working on Wonder Words?
Yeah, for the people that's watching, the app is available already, and maybe I will share with you the link, you know, for people it's possible to download.
Absolutely.
In Google Play, in Apple. Inside the app, I apply a Easter egg. For example, here, after I create an account, it's possible a gallery. It's a showcase for each component from mobile.
Oh, that's fantastic. Yeah. I didn't know that. That's a great Easter egg.
Yeah, because here, you can see in the preview in web is so different. For example, this scroll is not exist in real mobile, but here, first user that does not have access in mobile editor, experience, try how this component works. Then horizontal, I like so much this selectable list. It's so good because it's like a multi drop down option. The short list, but sheets for me is the best because it's so common in mobile. Né? I think all app that I use, né, in social media is possible to send information inside the sheet, apply another components. And here it's so interesting because we have conditional that is possible to control the object inside the sheet. It's so detailed, so different settings and configuration in this component.
Can I see what that conditional looks like? I'm curious if it's kind of like, if it's similar to like the conditional when current page width.
Yeah, let me share here. Let me share.
Yeah, where's your Easter egg view?
Here we have, apply the sheet component here. There is so this snap point, so interesting this feature because it's possible to control how the sheet will occupy in the screen. And inside, like a view, because I put image, text, maybe a short list, maybe another component, he applied the conditional sheet current snap point, the full snap point, there is hover pressed. So I like so much this feature, these details that control micro behavior inside this component, micro behavior.
That's awesome. You built the mobile version of this app off of an existing web app. And that web app used AI. So I assume that you had an API connection and everything. Did you have to modify the API connection at all when repurposing it for mobile views?
No. This is a strong point from this approach, because the same action, a schedule API workflow is the same. Because, for example, here, let me share. Here, I have the action in button. I have some validation, but here, schedule API flow that starts the process is totally the same in mobile from web.
I'm curious, like, when you first got access to native mobile, and you were able to see that most of everything that you were building was in the same place, did you feel like you were able to like hit the ground running and start working on your mobile app, or was there anything that took you by surprise?
No. The manual from Bubble, so important, is a good approach to start reading, because it many details about how to use these new components, the view, mobile action. There is different approach because there is new events like tap, pressed. Then it's important to read here. It's so short, compare a web platform manual is much more information. I think I need to congrats the team Bubble about the deploy. Deploy is so good organized and work for me very well. I would like to share some details, because deploy to App Store is not a easy approach normally. But I would like to share that I build and publish an app in App Store, Apple App Store, without using a MacBook, without using a Mac. It's not a regular approach, because to create certificates, other things, technical stuff to publish, usually the developer needed to have a MacBook, Mac computer. Then it's not necessary. There is in manual step-by-step information how configure settings, create an account, develop in Apple Store, in Google Play. You need to apply all this information and only deploy here. It's possible to deploy web and mobile. Two different kinds. It's possible to create a new build that you will send to App Store. Or over there is so a great approach, because over there some details change, a button change, a color, a small change in your project. Over there is fantastic, because the update is the same time. I like transparent for user, and more complex changes is recommended a new build. But here, serious, I never seen a feature like that in another platform.
You talked us through the Sheets component, and you talked us through this like Easter egg feature that you build. Is there another feature on the mobile app that you were able to build with Bubble that you're especially proud of?
You can talk about push notification. Push notification is a traditional, so common feature in mobile apps. The team, the Bubble team, is congrats also, because when there is a workflow to use push. When you use start to use your app, maybe after create an account, there is a specific action. You need first to request a push notification permission. It's so common, the pop-up, the model to accept. the first step, then after you create a screen, an admin screen, to send title, subtitle, some details in push notification, then it's possible to search for the users that accept the receive the push using device table. Device table is a native table like user bubble create in automatic way that it's not possible to change. You can maybe filter for some constraint. Or I think in this moment the best approach is send push notification for all users. Yeah. Then it's a so strong feature, so common feature in mobile environment. Then, for example, I create here a specific screen to send you. Now, you don't need to use another platform. Inside your own project, create a screen to put the information and send the push notification.
So you said the time between when you first got access to native mobile to your first deployment, you said that was about...
A few days, maybe 1 week.
Do you have any future plans for Wonder Words, or do you kind of feel like you closed out what you wanted from this project and are ready to move on to the next one?
I think about to transform this project in a real project, maybe monetize in any way, but I think I offer to transform mobile some real project that I have for clients.
We'll make sure to include the link to where you can find the app in the App Store in the description.
Yeah, certainly.
Thanks so much, Felipe.
Yeah, have a nice day.
To download Wonder Words, check out the links in the description. If you'd like to build your own apps in Bubble for iOS or Android, Native Mobile will be entering public beta on June 10th. We'll be hosting a launch webinar that day that you won't want to miss, so make sure to sign up for that event using the link in the description. Until then, thanks for watching.